So what is a drive? A drive is a device that allows us to control an electric motor. Well, why is that then important? Well, if we would have a standard AC motor connected to an electrical grid, it will start rotating, but it will rotate at a fixed speed. So meaning we have two alternatives, zero speed or full speed. Now, if we compare this to driving a car, where you would have only a throttle with only two positions, zero power or full power, how could you manage to control the speed of your car? Impossible to do. Instead, you have a throttle pedal that lets you adjust the power of the engine to get the suitable speed of your car to match the traffic. Now, this drive works in the same way. It's our throttle pedal. It's also connected to the electrical grid, but instead of feeding the power directly to the motor, it converts the energy. And that allows us to very accurately control both the speed and the torque of the electrical motor, meaning throttling our engine. Now, let's do a live demonstration on using a drive compared to a standard directly connected motor. Let's see how we can adjust the speed and how we can save energy. We have a demo setup here with a motor directly connected to a fan, which will then get an airflow through this tube and this ball will go up. Now I start the motor and it will run at full speed. We cannot control the speed of the motor, so we cannot control the flow either. But we can use this kind of a throttling valve to reduce the flow so we get what we want. Now we have a suitable airflow, and let's have a look at how much power the motor needs in this position. We can see that it's almost 90 watts is the power that the motor is taking from the network. Now I will stop the motor. Instead, I will start the VFD, the variable frequency drive, and then I will smoothly increase the speed of the motor, meaning that I will adjust the flow. Now we get the motor rotating, we get more flow, and now we have our operating point that we want to have. Now let's have a look at the power meter. Less than 20 watts. So this is what it means to accurately control the speed of the motor to actually suit the position of the application. Electric motors and drives are practically used everywhere. For example, controlling the ventilation here in our office, controlling the tap water, your drinking water, taking care of the wastewater, controlling an elevator going up and down, your tram, your metro. You find these applications everywhere. Not even to talk about heavy industry, where all the machines are controlled by the electrical motors. And did you know that electric drives and drive systems have been around for like 50 years? The pioneering work to develop this technology for low voltage AC drives was actually made here in this campus area by Mr. Martti Harmoinen and his team. And in 1975, the world's first commercial AC drive was delivered to a customer here in Finland. So come with me, let's have a look at what the drive looked like at that time. All right, let's have a look at one of the first drives ever manufactured. This one was manufactured in 1979. Let's have a look. As you can see, the physical size is like a large refrigerator, and the output power from this device was approximately 10 kilowatts at that time. So this is what the typical drive in the same output power, 10 kilowatt, looks like today. When the drive converts energy, it creates some losses, meaning it generates heat. We need to be able to remove that heat from the drive. Typically we do that with air cooling, meaning that we have a fan in the module, which is then pushing the air through the drive. The heat is transferred through the heat sink to the air and pushed out from the drive. That's a typical way. But we have other options to make the cooling as well. If we are talking about very large drives, high powers, also the losses increase. We can actually use liquid to cool the drive. Here we have an example of a liquid cooled drive. As you can see, it's a large cabinet. It's not only one drive, it actually includes several drives. But let's look at the cooling. So now, instead of air, we are rotating liquid through the drive, through the power modules, and then we are removing the heat losses and taking them through the coolant and out from the cabinet. This cooling method compared to air is approximately 3,000 times better because of what comes from the heat transfer capability from liquid, and that also allows us to really build drives that has a very small footprint. An example of that is, let me open this door to show you. Behind this door we have two liquid cooled power modules. Now these are both controlling one motor. The nominal output power of these is 1600 kilowatt. If we compare this to the drive from 1979 with 10 kilowatt, almost the same space, from these liquid cooled power modules we can get out almost 160 times more power from the same footprint. This is the cooling unit or the pump station that actually rotates the liquid inside the drive cabinet. We have pumps here for rotating the cold liquid to the drive modules and the drive cabinet and back here through the heat exchanger, and then we can transfer all the heat losses out from the drive to the external circuit. This includes the pump, the measurement gauge, temperature meters, pressure meters and so on, and then we have automated in everything, so everything works like autonomously. As we are using liquid for cooling, it also means that we don't need to push any air through the drive cabinet for the cooling. The liquid does that. Now what does this then mean? This means that the whole drive cabinet can be totally enclosed, and that makes it very robust in harsh conditions. There is no air going through the cabinet itself, meaning that if there is any dust or other impurities in the air, it won't go into the drive. This is beneficial for certain segments, especially heavy industry, pulp and paper plants, metals factories, where there might be some dust or other impurities that could go into the drive and could cause a challenge for a standard air-cooled drive. But the largest segment by far using these liquid-cooled drives is the marine segment. The main reason is the compact size and the footprint of a liquid-cooled drive, but also the fact that there is a huge transition going on in the marine segment, going from traditional diesel engines towards alternative fuels like LNGs, but also hybrid systems and full electric systems. And this technology helped them to achieve the goals that they have to cut the emissions and to have a better efficiency on the vessel. This drive technology that we have here, of course it can control the propulsion and the thrusters, but it helped the customers to achieve these hybrid and full electric systems. Our drive technology can integrate to different kinds of generators, shaft generators, we can integrate to different kinds of energy storages like batteries, we can use the device in a full electric vessel to actually create an AC grid instead of using a generator. And that's probably something that was not in the scope when the drive was actually developed 50 years ago. But during to this old technology and new, let's say, requirements, we have developed all these features. So now we can use the drive technology to help the marine to cut the emissions and to reach their efficiency goals that are set by the more and more tight regulation. Now we are at the drives factory. Here we manufacture some tens of thousands of drives per year. Another way to compare that amount is to calculate how much installed electrical power these drives actually are per year. Last year we produced drives that have an installed power of approximately 20 gigawatts. That's comparable to actually 20 nuclear plants. The drive can save energy as it controls the motor, adapts the speed and the torque so that it's always optimal for the process. So it helps to save energy. We estimate that some 25% of energy can be saved by using these drives to control the motors. Now we are talking about 5 nuclear power plants. Energy saving from our factory only and for 1 year manufacturing. And we have similar factories in several other countries as well. So that means that our technology actually helps to save huge amount of energy in the global world. Thank you for watching this video. We hope that this gives information about what is a drive, what is liquid cooling in a drive, and why this is so important, especially for heavy industry and the marine segment. This technology helps to save energy reach the sustainability goals and to work towards a world with net zero emissions.